Dear students, let me teach some important aspect in law and practice of banking. Check. As you know, it is important from the point of view of examination and also for the sake of knowledge. What is check? So you might have seen check books, check leaves. You might have used also, but we have to study it as per the Indian Negotiable Instrument Act, which came into existence in 1881. So that act gives the definition for check also. What does it say? It says that as per section 6 of Indian Negotiable Instrument Act 1881, check is a bill of exchange. It is also one negotiable instrument, that is bill of exchange. So it is drawn on a specified banker and not expressed to be payable otherwise than on demand. Demand is compulsory. If there is no demand, check cannot be payable. So the person, the holder of the check has to come to bank for the payment. So only on demand it is payable. Then how it will be appeared? How it should be? So what are the essentials of a check? First thing is, it is a written instrument. That means check compulsorily should be in a written form. It is an unconditional order. That means you cannot put any kind of conditions along with the check. For example, you may say orally that if you get through the examination, if you pass the examination, then only I will give you the money. But that condition should not be written on the check. You cannot prepare a check with condition. It is an unconditional order. Then on a specified banker only. Every banker will be having his own format of checks. So a check means it is related to that particular respective banker. So on a specified banker only it can be drawn. Payable in money only. When the check is produced in the bank, you will get the money. So banker gives only money, not the coins. You can't ask any banker to give 2 kgs sugar, 10 kgs rice, etc. So money is the only mode of payment. And pay it to be certain. So on the check leaf, it is payable to dash. You have to mention the name of the person to whom the payment has to be made. So payee must be certain. So you cannot write whomsoever it is concerned. No, you have to specifically write a name. You have to mention the person to whom the payment has to be made. It is payable on demand. Means demand is compulsorily, it's a condition. Only on demand the payment can be made. And it is payable on demand. The amount of the check should be mentioned. Compulsorily, it should be specifically mentioned. And dating of check. Compulsorily, check should bear one date. So, date is also very important aspect. As you know very well, it should not be a future date. And it should not be anti-date. That means old date before 3 months. After 3 months, check becomes dead or it cannot be in existence. You cannot make the payment. So only within 3 months, check has to be presented. Therefore, date of the check is very, very important. Delivery of the check. Check has to come to bank, should be produced in the bank, then only the payment can be made. And it should be signed by the maker. The person who prepares the check, who gives the check, should sign on it. These are the essentials. When these conditions are fulfilled, then only you can say that it is a valid check. Checks are classified into two. It may be order check or bearer check. Then what is order check? Order check contains an order to pay the value of check to a certain person or to his order. That means here the person's name is important. What is written on the check? To him or to his order, the amount will be paid. Then what is bearer check? It is a check payable to the bearer or possessor. Here, name is not mentioned on the check. The bearer or the person who bears it, who holds it, who presents it, get the money. Then, important aspect about the check is crossing. What do you mean by crossing? Drawing two parallel lines on the face of the check is called as crossing. Why crossing is made? See here, crossing can be understood well with the help of two types of crossings. General crossing, special crossing. Drawing two parallel transverse lines on the face of check with or without mentioning some words is called as general crossing. So you may or may not write any words. Only when there are two transverse lines on the face of the check, it is called as general crossing. So mentioning name of the banker on the face of the check in addition with crossing is special crossing. Here in special crossing, what is the addition? What the new thing you have done? That is, you have mentioned the name of the banker. Canara Bank only, SBI only. That means what? It has to be submitted through SBI only. The person who wants to take the amount, that is the payee, should be submitted the check to the bank mentioned on the check. That is called as special crossing. When this kind of name of the bank is not there, only two lines are there, it is called as general crossing. So, since both these general and special crossings are very important, let us understand these two important classifications by understanding the differential points. Okay. What are the differences between special crossing and general crossing? So, general crossing here, two parallel transverse lines are required. Okay. Two lines are to be drawn. But as far as special crossing is concerned, these two lines are not necessary. It may or may not be there on the face of the check. Okay. Second point, name of the collecting banker is not necessary in case of general crossing. Whereas in special crossing, name of the collecting banker is necessary. I hope you got the point. For general crossing, two transverse lines are important, but the name of the paying bank, collecting banker is not necessary. Whereas for special crossing, two transverse lines are not important. They may or may not be there. What should be there compulsorily? Name of the collecting banker. That is important for special crossing. And in case of general crossing, may be converted into special crossing. So earlier the check was in general crossing. Afterwards, you can convert it into special crossing. How you can convert? By adding the name of the collecting banker. So already there are two transverse lines. So it is general crossing. Afterwards, you are adding the name of the collecting banker. Then it will become the conversion from general crossing into special crossing. But you cannot, that means special crossing cannot be converted into general crossing. That means already you have mentioned the collecting banker's name. That means it is special crossing. Now you want to convert it into general crossing. You want to delete it. You want to remove the name of the collecting banker, which is not possible. And in case of general crossing, it may have the words like and company, etc. But in case of special crossing, that it doesn't have any words. So I hope you have understood. So these two things are very important. So dear students, start your study, prepare well, remember all the earlier aspects what we have covered. So I will come with new aspect in my next video. Take care.